Hey guys, my name is Gregory. I'm a software engineer at HubSpot. It's amazing to be here today. Last year, almost everything was experimental, and today we see all this activity, mature frameworks, an increasing number of adopters, a great number of committers, Docker support, native Docker support, and we have also a dedicated conference for Mesos. This is all great news for all of us that we already use Mesos, but I think also it is great news for all you guys that you want to jump in and start using it. So, Singularity, the Mesos framework that we have created at HubSpot, has gained a considerable degree of maturity and stability the last couple of months, and we think that now it can be useful outside of the HubSpot environment. I want to share with you information on how we use it internally and how you could use it and integrate it in your deploy pipeline to run web services, background workers, and scheduled tasks in Mesos clusters. Singularity is implemented and maintained by the past team at HubSpot. We have decided lately to have a dedicated team that looks after all the cross-cutting concerns of our product. We're kind of multiplying the efforts, the delivery of our product teams, removing the obstacles, removing the barriers, removing the friction, and let them continuously enhance the product and innovate. By the way, today, two guys from my team, Whitney and Tom, are with us, so you can grab us later and for more questions and discussions, and we can give some demo also. So what is singularity? This is a mathematical singularity, nice and colorful. And this is our HubSpot singularity. I couldn't make it that colorful as the mathematical one, but still singularity has some great cool features. Singularity is a very well fit for microservice architecture environment. It is fine-tuned to deploy and manage the life cycle of web services. And at the same time, we support both long running and batch scheduling. In a way, having a consistent way to support all the different kinds of processes that the developer wants to deploy every day. You have already realized, I suppose, that in the Mesos ecosystem, most of the frameworks they are quite vertical inside the domain. Even inside the domain, they support a specific technology, for example, Hadoop or Spark. We took the completely opposite direction, and we want to have a unified environment and a consistent API to support all the different use cases. So how we went to the path to Mesos? For those that don't know HubSpot, we are an internet marketing company. So the decision to adopt Mesos was business-oriented and purely practical. We want the product that we have to be always current and always useful for our customers. And so we develop, we change, and we deploy most of the product features hundreds of times every day. So in order to accomplish this change rate, we wanted to remove the friction and also at the same time to keep the changes small and manageable so we can easily roll back. Step one, we went to create the proper culture and also lower the process overheads. We have very small teams, 3 to 4 persons, that they own the full stack of the product. They have great freedom on how they implement and they operate the features of the product. And then step two, we provide them with some nice libs and APIs, and then we allow them to very quickly create new microservices and jobs. We can create useful stuff within an hour. So at this point, we have managed to have less friction, and so we have almost hundreds of times of deploying our software. But now we have a new problem. How are we going to manage all this complexity? We ended up to have almost 1,000 of microservices, jobs, and workers that compose our product. how we manage all this complexity. Here is where Singularity and Mesos steps in and help us to create and automate a deployment infrastructure that allows our developers to not only create all the software and change it all the times, but also deploy it very easily. Some numbers so you can get a context. So today we run all our QA in a Mesos cluster, and we have already gradually start moving our production system to a new Mesos cluster. We, as I said, deploy about 400 times per day, about 150 times in the production environment, and we have close to 800 deployable items, and the current mix is that we have 220 web services. They are the APIs that compose the product. We have about 250 workers, for example, processes that could consume Kafka queues. We have almost 200 jobs. Jobs process Hadoop data and the create materialized views in HBase and some other stuff. And also we have a few on-demand jobs that we don't want to run them always, but we manually initiate them in order to move files around, to migrate databases, to clean up log files. Pre-Mesos, we were using 400 small AWS instances. Today, we use 20 quite big, hefty AWS servers. I think that most of you will now wonder what was the cost reduction. I think it was about 20%, but this was not the big win that we have. Actually, the big win for us at this stage is that we have managed to minimize the operational complexity, and we have a unified, a consistent way to manage all the use cases for our deploys. I suppose that in the long run, when we move everything to Singularity and Mesos, all our production environment, then cost would be also a big win. So why Singularity? For the past team, the developers are our customers. So we want to provide them with the best possible user experience. We want to give the developers a way to deploy continuously their software every time, anytime, every day. And we have 100 of them, so it's very important. We took a strategic decision that we want Singularity and Mesos not to be just a tool that is there for some people if they want to use it. We will move everything, and we have already started doing this, as I said before, to Singularity and Mesos. And you can understand that when we have this strategic decision and Singularity and Mesos becomes a mission critical and strategic tool, we would like to have some kind of influence in the roadmap and how we add new features and how we do the debugging. Another reason that we choose to implement our own framework is that we have been very early adopters. We started in 2012. At that time, there was no mature framework, and also somehow later that we tried to integrate the existing frameworks, we found out that the different abstractions that they were supporting were creating much more complexity that we wanted, and at the end of the day, we didn't get the use case that we wanted to have. Having said so, it does require a considerable amount of resources to have your own framework and to maintain it. And it needs a lot of effort. However, in HubSpot, we have been very lucky because at the same time that we did this strategic decision, we have also decided to create the PaaS team that now implements and supports Singularity. I have here a kind of workflow to tell you how we do it today, how we deploy. So we have a deploy config. It's very similar to what Aurora supports, a DSL. The representation is in YAML. So the developer creates this nice config and specifies the deployable items and the resources that wants for it, each deployable item, and puts this config inside the project. As the project is pushed to GitHub, it triggers some metadata about the deploy config to be written in a registry, and also we trigger the build of the artifacts. We write the artifacts in the artifact repository, for example, S3. And then, again, we write some more information about those artifacts. At that time, the developers are ready to deploy. We have a nice UI. They go, they select their deploy config, and then we create a deploy request that goes to this Mesos deploy service that we have created. This analyzes the deploy config, gets all the metadata that it requires, where are the builds, what build we want to do. We support also rollbacks. You can go back and to deploy something that is older if it doesn't work, what you have already done here. And at the end of the day, this Mesos deploy service creates API calls to Singularity. Singularity is a RESTful API, and we get the tasks in the Mesos. So Singularity, as every decent Mesos framework, implements a scheduler and an executor, and also we support some kind of utility services that can run at the level of the slave that make the life of developers easy. I want to stress again that our key goal is that we want the developers to be totally free, without any friction, to develop their code and deploy it and not worry about anything. We don't want them to worry about log files, how they will archive it, how they move it. We already had in the previous speech that this is a nice thing to do. So we don't want them to repeat in each job that they create, in each microservice, how they will manage the log files, how they manage the cleaning of the tasks, and so on. You can run the scheduler in high availability mode. We reuse the Zookeeper quorum, and also we use the Zookeepers to get the state of the active task, of the running task that Singularity manages. Of course, Zookeeper is not a database, so every now and then when we have tasks dying and completing, we move all this historical information to a MySQL database, and it's always available for you. A very cool feature is that we support load balancing out of the box, automated. We have a Singularity scheduler to use a load balancer API so it can load balance the instances of web services. And we have open sourced also, besides Singularity, this load balancer implementation for you. The cool thing here is that Singularity is a RESTful API. You can control all its operation through the provided endpoints. We support two key abstractions. The one is that you have deployable items. You send a Singularity request to register your item, and then you send deploy request to deploy it continuously, to roll back to a different build, and so on. You can use endpoints to go and see the files, the log files in the sandbox of each task, and of course you can get all the metadata and historical data about tasks that have already run and finished. You can use the API to create your own deploy tools above Singularity, but you don't really need to do so because we have a great UI already ready for you. I don't have time to tell more about this, but we can also we can give you a nice demo after if you are interested. We will be very happy with my colleagues. Just to get an idea, you can get the status of all your cluster. You can see that we run 844 tasks. You can drill down and see all the deployable items that are running in your cluster, and then you can click in your deployable item and see which are the tasks. This particular item was a web service, so we can see that it has two running instances. And we can see the task history. So you can see what was happening before these instances became active. You can also see the deploy history, how you change your deployable item, and much more. And you can go inside each instance and take a look at any file and take a look at all the log files. The cool things that the scheduler does for you today is that it supports very configurable health checking. So you can specify, for example, how much time Singularity should wait before it starts health checking. You can specify how much time it wait for each instance to become healthy and for the whole deploy to become healthy. And afterwards, the second step is that if everything is healthy, you can ask Singularity to go to the load balancer API and add your instances to the load balancer. And everything is automated, because if something dies, Singularity will go remove it from the load balancer, and if something goes up, then it will re-add it to the load balancer. It's very cool. And we also roll back everything automatically if something goes wrong. So if you deploy and something goes wrong, Singularity will move back to the previous successful deploy. You don't need to do anything about this. Another cool feature is that you can decommission the whole slave. You can move the whole bunch of tasks that run in the slave into another slave. And even for the racks, you can have logical racks, like for us is the whole availability zone. You can move the whole availability zone tasks in another availability zone. And we also send emails to the owners of the task every time that something fails. The executor does lock rotation for you, clean up all the task data after it finishes, so you don't end up with a slave that is full, with a full disk, and some other cool operations in order to set up complex environments. And as the last thing, we have some nice utilities. You can send your log files to Fluentd, to Logstash, and then to Elasticsearch, so you can have instant access to your log files and searching. You have automatic uploading to S3 for all the rotated log files, and we also clean up, because sometimes executors die, we also clean up all this mess that is created there. In order to finish, I have to say that Singularity is open source. It has a very nice and clean code, and we will be delightful to have contributions. We use Juice for injection of dependencies. We use Drop Wizard to create the endpoints, Maven to build it, and the UI is a single page app that is created with Backbone, Node.js, and Brands. And this is the roadmap. What we're going to do is to provide phase deployment so we can deploy in stages. We cannot do it now. We want, as already mentioned, to support auto scaling and monitoring the resources. Support Docker, of course. another thing that we would like very much to do is to open source the upper layers that I have already demonstrated that we use for deploying, so we will make even easier to use Singularity in your pipeline. And I have some useful links for you and an appendix that has some more information about the different objects that you can, and RESTful APIs that you can, endpoints that you can use in order to control the scheduler. That's it. Thank you very much.